Now, the discussion is all about forms of threads. Now, here the fasteners are the other name which are used to hold or join two or more parts or elements. So for example, I have given you an example. For example, if this is one plate and if I want to join these two plates, joining can be done by different ways. You can rivet them. Riveting is one option, or else you can weld them. This is also one option. And coming to nut and bolt arrangement, that can also be done. For example, I can wait a minute if you are joining. Now I can drill a hole through from top to bottom, then I can make arrangement of a bolt from the top, something like this. The other side of the bolt will come out, and from the bottom I'll arrange a nut, something like this. Okay, so that these two plates, plate number 1 and 2, will be in alignment, and that can be used for some process. Okay, this is one way. So here, what kind of bolt has to be used and what type of threads should be fixed or used for so and so purpose. Okay, so we have different types of threads. The other day I was discussing, like, for example, first one, sharp V thread number 1, and number 2 Whitworth, number 3 square thread, number 4 Acme, number 5 warm thread, 6 buttress thread. Now these are the different types of threads or thread profiles that you need to learn, their standard specifications, that is more important. Okay, now each and every thread has its own importance. Coming to V sharp or sharp V thread, where larger contact area is required in such, for example, I just erase this portion, I'll make a point here. V sharp thread is used where much contact area is required. This is used in case where contact area nothing but in between two elements or two parts, the contact area, if the contact area required is higher, then contact area should be larger. In such cases, they'll go with some V sharp type of thread. Okay, now the descriptive questions will not be asked. There won't be any somebody unmuted. You won't find any descriptive kind of questions in case of machine drawing question paper. Okay, they'll ask you to draw the thread profile of V sharp, or as draw the thread profile of Whitworth, draw the thread profile of warm thread by considering some pitch value. P is equal to some value will be given to you. Okay, based on that value, we need to calculate things accordingly. We need to perform the task. I'll show you how to draw also. Already I have discussed it with other section students. Okay, the same discussion we'll have in depth today. So this particular V sharp thread, as I said, this profile is used where larger contact area is required, where it can provide more frictional resistance. This kind will provide more frictional resistance. Coming to the next one, Whitworth, this kind of thread profile. Now this profile will have a round cross section, something like this. You don't have sharp tips on the top, something like this. Whereas in case of V sharp, the thread profile is sharp. Crust and trough, if you look at, the thread profiles are sharp. Okay, now it is going to maintain an angle of 60 degrees. It is going to maintain an angle of 60 degrees, whereas Whitworth will maintain, this will maintain an angle of 55 degrees. This we call it as an internal angle, and this we call it as external angle. This is external angle, and this has internal angle. Okay, similarly for this particular V sharp also, this is how it is going to be. And coming to buttress, let us I am going to give you some briefing about these thread profiles firstly, then we'll move on to drawing them. Okay, coming to square thread, this thread profile has the same width and same height, which is 0.5 into p. P is nothing but the pitch distance. Now this enables the nut to transmit very high pressures. This square profile, thread profile, will enable the nut to transmit very high pressures. Okay, where this kind is used in case of screw jacks. Screw jack is used to lift the load. For example, in case of your four wheeler, if you want to lift the body, we use a jack. So in such cases, this kind of thread profiles are used. And coming to Acme thread, this is a modified form. Now more or less square and Acme both are almost similar, but this Acme is somewhat modified form of a square thread. Now comparatively, if you'll see, Acme is more stronger than square thread. It is more stronger than square thread, and also wider, and it is easy to, you know, fasten and unfasten. That is one of the advantage of using Acme, which is much stronger compared to square thread. And the fifth one, warm thread. This warm thread, it is used on shafts to carry power to warm wheels. Okay, but descriptive part, as I am giving you some points related, nobody will ask you in the examination about the descriptive part of so and so threads. They'll ask you to draw the profiles. That is more and more important. And coming to buttress, it is a combination of V and square thread. This particular buttress thread is a combination of sharp V and square thread. This one, third one. Okay, it is a combination of these two. So with the combination, it will go, which will maintain two different angles, theta 1 and theta 2. All those discussions we'll have now. Okay, so roughly I'll just conclude. V sharp is used where larger contact area is required, whereas Whitworth is a profile used for making, what you call it as, it is almost similar to V sharp, but the top tips has some radius of 0.14 p, where the contact area is less comparatively. You can compare these two. Coming to square thread, having a width and thickness or height, both are same, 0.5 p, and used in case of screw jacks, best example. Acme is one which is a variant of square thread, which is much stronger compared to square thread. And coming to warm thread, it is a combination of V sharp and buttress is a combination of V sharp and square thread, and warm thread is again a form of Acme. Okay, again it is going to maintain different angles, that we'll discuss now. Okay, why we required fastening means to join two elements together. This discussion will, you know. Now let me clear the window and draw a simple profile just to make you understand the terminology. I'm going to draw a simple sketch here. Let us imagine this as a profile. All right. Now here, look at the terminology now. For example, if this is a thread profile, we call this as the internal thread, and we call this as the external thread. All right. And in case of V sharp, you have a sharp tip, whereas in case of Whitworth, you find this kind, a profile with fillet, top fillet. This is how it is going to be. Okay, so here the terminology is, this we call it as internal thread, this as the external thread, followed by, whenever you talk about internal thread, in our diameter D, we call it as a major dia. Diameter D, call it as major dia. You have two more terms called D1 and D2. this d1 d2 called as minor diameter and major, sorry, d2 is called pitch dia. This is the simple terminology when it comes to metric screw thread. Okay, no need to, just to have an idea I'm telling you all the stuff, but more importantly we need to know about the types of profiles and how to draw those types of profile. Okay, firstly I'll take sharp V thread. Now let us see how to draw this profile. Now sharp V thread, the name itself indicates you have, the thread will have a tip, a vertex point, something like this. Now it is going to maintain an angle of 60 degrees and profile height of 0.87 p. this is also fine. Now the distance from one peak to the next, this is called the pitch distance, p. pitch distance is, pitch is represented with p, and this distance is called pitch distance. Okay, or else you can consider between two troughs also, two crusts. Okay, this is p. Now in the exam or in the question, p value will be given to you. P is equal to some 6 mm or 9 mm or 10 or 12, whatever the number you get. Based on that you need to calculate h is equal to 0.87 p, theta is equal to 60 degrees, and p is already given in the question. Based on these terms we need to calculate them all and we need to draw the thread profile. Okay, I'll show you now how to draw a simple thread profile of this kind, V sharp. For that, let me consider a scale. I'll draw two parallel lines. I'll just try to draw two parallel lines. Here, above and below. Okay, you need to start thread profile or any component with 2H pencil only all the time. Okay, after this make a mark somewhere on the top. I'm just making a mark where I could measure an angle of 60 degrees on either sides. Okay, with respect to this marking, what I try to do is I'll try to split the angle into 30 30. Okay, so let me rotate the scale to 30 degrees. 30 degrees, something like this. Okay, as of now I'm not following any accurate dimensions. What I try is with respect to, wait a minute, yes, let me keep it to 90 degrees. Now if this is maintaining 90, now I need to go with 30 on either sides. With respect to the vertical line I need to go with 30 degrees. Now 80 70 60, this is how you need to draw. Okay, with respect to vertical I'm making it 30 degrees and drawing the profile. Okay, to the other side also do the same practice. Once you fix these lines properly, then no need to measure the angle all the time. You can take the parallel lines. Okay, one angle I have fixed here. Now this angle, let me move the last scale. Now this angle is theta, which is equal to 60 degrees I have maintained. Okay, from the top. Now again, to draw the next peak or the next thread profile, no need to measure the angle again. Just take this scale, which is now aligned with the first line, and here align with the top corner and simply drop a line. Similarly, rotate the scale to another clockwise direction and try to align or match with this profile. Now obviously it is making 60. You can straight away place it here and drop the line. So if you are using a protractor, no need to measure the angle all the time, simply drop lines of this kind. Okay, again this line, something like this you'll get. Okay, now here the overall height maintained is 0.87 p, the offset distance, theta is the angle maintained. Accordingly, after drawing the profile, again you need to write down the standards. H is equal to 0.87 p, theta is equal to 60 degrees, and p is equal to the whatever the value given. All right, this is how you need to do. And other than this, now this red color lines above and below, you need to draw with only 2H pencil. Okay, and the required projection need to be darkened by HB pencil. Something like this. All right, after this, again draw one more parallel line below for all the profiles, not only for this profile. Below I'll try to draw one more 2H line at some offset distance and align your drafter to 45 degrees inclination. Start drawing the hatching lines. 1, there is only 10 minutes left, ma. After this, again try to join the session. Why we do hatching? Because you would like to show that it is a cutted portion. Something like this. Maintain an angle of 45 degrees and offset distance of 2 mm. This is what we need to draw to get a proper profile. Okay, so it is going to take enough time, so I'll just try to draw with free hand. This is how you need to do. All right, you got this profile. Now let this horizontal line remain same with 2H and draw the profile for all the types of threads. Now let us go with the second one. The second profile is, let me take it as Whitworth. This is Whitworth thread. Again, to draw a Whitworth thread, what we do? Again, calculate H value. H is equal to 0.64 p. We need to remember these standard specifications. Theta is equal to 55 degrees in case of Whitworth, and radius R is equal to 0.14 p. All right. So if this is the case, and now what we need to do, again consider H, draw two parallel lines above and below with 2H pencil, and now similar kind of profile you'll get, but other than that you'll have a fillet over here, top and bottom you have fillet, something like this. So there won't be a sharp tip, something like this you'll get. So to get that, again what we need to do is, wait a minute. Okay, so here what we need to do is just straight away make a mark. As I said, it is going to maintain an angle of 55 degrees. You need to split that into two. okay, nothing but 27.5 degrees. Okay, so from here what I try is, I'll try to with respect to vertical we need to trace, okay, just drop an axis line with 2H pencil again, use an angle, I mean the radius of 0.14p. from here, from the intersection point, make a mark of 0.14p and the same radius with the help, this as center, with the help of compass, draw the curve. Okay, this curve is maintaining a radius of 0.14p with respect to the center. Similarly, now pitch distance we need to measure from this point. From this point, if I measure a pitch distance, the pitch will be maybe up to this point. Okay, so again I do the same practice. This as intersection, I'll drop a curve something like this with 0.14p. similarly, p by 2, at a distance of p by 2, I'll drop one more curve, okay, with the same concept. Here you'll get one more curve something like this. After drawing this curve, simply draw a tangential line between these two curves as well as these two tangential line. For example, I'll go with a scale this time. I'll just align in such a way that the line should pass through both the curves tangentially, something like this. All right, something like this. I'll just keep it and try to draw a straight line in a similar way to the other side. Also rotate and place it, draw, join them both. Okay, in the same way, try to place other peaks also. Try to draw the lines something like this. Okay, after this, again same whatever we have practiced, draw a parallel line to H, draw hatchings maintaining a gap of 2 mm and 45 degrees inclination, something like this. Okay, now here the height maintained is 0.64p and the radius here is 0.14p. The angle that we need to maintain is 55 degrees overall. 55 degrees theta is equal to 55 degrees. All right, so we need to remember this standard. Whenever you get a question based on Whitworth thread, you need to know its height, you need to know its angle and radius. That is important. All right, now after Whitworth, I'll go with buttress thread. Buttress thread. Now this buttress is somewhat different. Here it will have theta 1 and theta 2. Theta 1, let me call it as 45 degrees it will take, and theta 2 7 degrees. Height, coming to the height of this profile, it is 0.66p, and you have a small width also, which is 0.16p. now we need to justify all the four specifications, and pitch value p will be given, which will be given to you. Okay, based on the pitch, h w has to be calculated accordingly. Draw the profile. Okay, to do that, I'll consider h value 0.66p and let me draw let me decrease the thickness. I'm drawing two parallel lines at an offset distance of h. then after that, I'll simply drop a reference line. I'll drop one reference line here which is vertical. Now from that reference line, I'll draw one more line which is deviating from the actual vertical, something like this. Okay, now here the angle maintained in between is supposed to be 7 degrees. Okay, let me take another color. Okay, the angle maintained is 7 degrees. After that, from here drop a straight line, drop a straight line of width 0.16 p. okay, and drop this line. This should be darker again. This is fine. And from this point, align your drafter to 45 degrees to the downside and drop a straight line. Now whatever the width weighted here, 0.16 p, same width could see here to the bottom side. Okay, and from here again draw a line which should not be vertical, which should deviate to 7 degrees. Again 0.16 p, again 45 degrees. Try to understand, if you draw first profile properly, then no need to worry about others. Simply drop this line 0.16 p, then a 45 degrees line. Okay, then the hatching remains. So here this should be vertical, this should be 7 degrees. It is vertical here, this should be 7 degrees, and a 45 degrees inclination. Now this angle with respect to vertical is 7 degrees, so that 7 degrees you have to maintain throughout. And this width is 0.16 p. wait, this is 0.16 p, this is also maintaining same 0.16 p altogether. Okay, and here this angle is, this line is maintaining angle of 45 degrees, that is with respect to the vertical. With respect to this vertical, this is maintaining an angle of 45 degrees. Alright, so if this is maintaining 45, this is also maintaining 45 degrees. So all will go one after the other in a similar fashion. Again, for the same profile, draw a straight line at some offset distance to place the hatching. And this hatching should maintain angle of 45 degrees with a gap of 2 mm, something like this. Okay, this is important again. So you need to remember, in case of buttress, data will be given, p value will be given. You need to remember two angles, 7 degrees and 45. Height is 0.66 p, w is 0.16 p. there is no logic behind, the only thing is you need to remember, need to mug up things. Okay, so accordingly you need to draw the profile. Ultimately, once you finish off the complete sketch with 2H pencil, finally darken the profile which is actually required. Okay, the profile which is required, or elevation which is required, has to be darkened. This you can do by using small scale. Something like this. Okay. Now after this, one more profile is square thread. Square thread. Now coming to this square thread, as I said, thickness and width both will maintain same. So h is equal to 0.5 p. similarly, width is also equal to 0.5 p. both are equal. So if both are equal, then draw a line, draw two lines parallel to each other of 0.5 p gap. The in between gap is 0.5 p. Then let me draw thin lines. Let me draw thin lines, and after drawing these two thin lines, again maintain a width of 0.5 p. To maintain that width of 0.5 p, here I'll make a mark of 0.5 from here to here, one marking, and this line will come down from here to here, one more marking, and this will go up. Something like this. And so it should maintain equidistance now, which the required profile you need to darken. This profile you need to darken. This is the required profile visible. This is visible. As I'm drawing with free hand, unable to make it straight. This is how a square thread look like. Okay, now here this is 0.5 p, and this height is also 0.5 p. Simple. Now the angle here it is going to maintain is 90 degrees. That no need to tell, as you know about a square, followed by simple patterning. Pattern. All right, maintaining an angle of 45 degrees with an offset of 2 mm. Theta is equal to 45 degrees, and offset is equal to 2 mm. Offset nothing but the gap in between two lines. This is about a simple square thread or a profile, thread profile. Again, coming to Acme thread, now as I said, Acme is almost equivalent to square thread. Only thing is the angle it is going to maintain, in between angle it is going to maintain is 29 degrees. So here again, two parallel lines which is maintaining a height of 0.5 p, height is 0.5 p, width is also 0.5 p, but not the in between middle width, axis width. Here it is going to maintain is 0.5 p. So here what I try to do is try to make a mark of 0.5 p here. From here, let us imagine from here to this point, it is maintaining 0.5 p width, because this line should pass exactly from the center of both the lines above and below. If this is 0.5 p, this is maintaining 0.5 p, and the angle theta it is going to maintain is 29 degrees. So 29 divide, split the angle into 2, okay, 14.5 degrees on either sides. So align your drafter to 14.5 degrees and draw a line below and above, something like this. This one also. So this width will be maintained, because this width is not given to you in the profile. So if you maintain this 0.5 p properly, then if you could draw 14.5 degrees from top to bottom, wherever this line go and meet top and bottom horizontals, there you find this width. Similarly, once you get the profile, maintain same width here also. I'll just change the color, this width, okay, and this is a required profile. Now, if you know this width, similarly draw that width, and at an angle of 14.5 degrees, drop an inclination. Again, the same width, 14.5. Again, the same width, 14.5. Something like this kind of profile you'll get. Now, coming to the pitch value is placed something like this. Pitch value is measured in case of Acme from this point of 0.5p to the next starting point of 0.5p. This distance is pitch distance. This is how it need to be maintained. Okay, so here points to be remembered are 0.5p is the height, theta is equal to 29 degrees, pitch value will be given to you, and this width is 0.37p. okay, without maintaining this 0.37p, I have drawn the complete profile. Okay, out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dimensions or 5 standards, out of 5 standards, if you could maintain any 4 standards properly, then you can make it. Okay, easily you can make the profile, that is so easy. And finally, buttress thread. Again, hatching is required for this profile also. Don't forget to draw hatching. Go through the textbook, you find these profiles. Follow KL Narayanan, the soft copy which I have sent you, and try to draw all the thread profiles. Similarly, coming to the warm thread, warm thread is having a height of 0.69p and a width like we have seen in case of Acme, width is of 0.34p, theta is equal to again same 29 degrees, pitch value is a given value. And this is the case in case of warm also. Draw 2 parallel lines, place this width first, 0.34p, place it somewhere, 0.34p, from there 14.5 degrees on either sides, you get the profile. What I did, I have taken only 0.34, 29 degrees. Other, this height, okay, so accordingly you'll get follow the same width here also, drop the line. This line again, you can align with this line and draw it, the same width, align with this scale, align the scale with this inclination and drop the parallel line. With this inclination, width, same line, something like this you'll get. Only difference is here the height is 0.69p, height is bit higher when you compare with Acme. Okay, again thread profiles, hatching, all are similar. Okay, this is what you need to do. Try to go through forms of threads, where the most important topic, easiest one, if you could remember these 6 standards, you may get 2 or 3, they may ask you 2 or 3 profiles for 5 marks or for 10 marks. Okay, so this is what you need to perform. After this, the topic which we are going to discuss is keys. Keys is the topic that we are going to discuss after this, and riveted joints. The most important topic is riveted joints. Before I close the session, let me wait a minute. Here, yes, wait. The next topic we'll see is riveted joints. Here I'll show you one small video based on now. All of you, please go through this video. Okay, riveted joints, because immediately after hexagonal nut bolt arrangement, if you go through riveted joints, it becomes easy for you to understand. Now, as I said in the beginning, those two plates, those two rectangular plates I could connect with the help of nut and bolt. The same arrangement I can fix it with the help of a rivet also, with the help of a rivet, which is called a permanent joint, whereas nut bolt arrangement is a temporary joint where if you want you can unfasten, you can disassemble also, whereas in case of riveted joints you can't unfasten it, it is a permanent joint. Okay, riveted is a permanent joint. So here how the arrangement is going to be, I'm going to tell you. This kind of arrangements is used in case of boilers, in case of railway bogey manufacturing, all right, or else you could see the same in case of your buses, day-to-day traveling buses. All these are done with sheet metal work, okay, as they are fabricated with sheet metal work, the sheets can be fixed or attached permanently with the help of riveters. Okay, let us consider this rectangular plate as one sheet and this as the next sheet. If I want to join these two sheets together permanently, what I try here is I'll simply, let me call this first one as T1, second one as T2, and when I place one sheet over the other, you call it as a lap joint, LAP. You have, I mean, I think you know from your basic workshop where you try to place your sheets, okay, tin smithy sheets one over the other to make spot welding. Okay, similarly the next one is butt joint. When you place sheets one beside the other, that arrangement we call it as a butt joint. Okay, now if these two sheets are placed one over the other, now from top to bottom I just drill a through hole and place, as I told you in the beginning, hexagonal nut and bolt arrangement. I can fix those two. From the bottom I'll try to place a nut, something of this kind, to fix these two. But this is not a permanent joint. Here whenever required I can unfasten it, but few applications will be there where unfastening should not be done. Okay, there should not be any scope to open it. Okay, so in such scenario what we'll try to do is we'll try to go with, again I'm drawing those two sheets, placing one over the other, and in case of riveted joints what we'll try to do is I'll try to use a snap headed shank body. What is that? I'll show you. Snap head is nothing but this kind, semicircular head, and this portion is called a shank. Okay, now this shank portion is having some taper section. Shank portion is having a taper section on either sides. Okay, just thus taper section will help you to insert from top to bottom where you have a clearance. Top side it will fix properly, but as the shank moves down slowly, there you find a clearance between the material and the shank portion. So to fill those two together, what we'll try to do is we'll try to prepare a mold. We'll try to prepare a mold, and with the help of hydraulic press or pneumatic press, what we'll try to do is the mold shape, the cavity shape is made of snap head shape. Whatever the head, kind of type of head we are using, with the same type we'll try to prepare a mold. Now when we go in depth discussion, we will try to see all the dimensions. Today I'm giving you a small introduction about riveted joints, which is our next topic. Okay, now this snap head is maintaining 1.6D diameter and a height of 0.70, and instead of hexagonal bolt, what I try to do is I'll try to insert a shank. Now this is the mold which has to be prepared. Now this mold, this curve should have dimension of same whatever maintained for snap head, 1.6D and 0.70, so that we can press from the bottom. When you press the shank portion from the bottom, then what happens? The gap will be filled. I'll show you the arrangement. Just wait. If I'll show you the arrangement, then only you'll understand. Let us imagine these are the two plates, T1, T2, and there is a hole from top to bottom. I'm trying to place the shank from the top. Okay. When you try to place the shank or the snap headed shank from the top, as it is maintaining some taper session, hole is a parallel hole, then you have a clearance there. So then what we try, this kind of clearance, have a look. What we try to do is, from the bottom, I'll try to place this mold made of 1.6D by 0.7D and press with the help of pneumatic or hydraulic, and the space which is having some clearance will be filled with the shank material. Okay, that space will be filled with the shank material, and that will be pressed with the help of hydraulic or pneumatic arrangement. Then when it got solidified, it will fix properly. Okay, the material is maybe made of steel. Okay, it all depends on the kind of requirement or environment we are using it, how big loads, how tough loads it is going to take, loads or pressures. Accordingly, we'll try to change the material. But the dimensions of the snap head or any type of head, not only snap head, you have different types of heads that we are going to deal with. But most importantly, snap head, if you understand one particular rivet, then it becomes easy to understand other things also. All right, if that is the case, have a look. I'm trying to represent three-dimensionally whatever I have explained you. When you look at the component three-dimensional, it will look something like this. I would like to fix these two sheets. Okay, if that is the case, it will look something like this. Okay. Now, this is a simple explanation I have given. Now, when it comes to actual drawing, when I look at the component from the front, only I could see the thickness of both the sheets, not the overall length. Now, the sheet length could be any number, okay, meters of sheet you find, but you can't place the exact dimensions on the sheet of paper. So, we'll try to minimize things, scale down things, and project it on a sheet of paper. All right, let me forward this. That arrangement has to be represented. Means you need to draw the front view. When a riveted arrangement is done on two sheets, you need to show the front view, top view of that particular arrangement. That is what I am trying to do. I'll just go a bit faster. If this is the riveted arrangement, then how the top view look like? The top view, I'm going to draw here. Draw a parallel line to this. Measure the 1.5D is the width, and 0.7D is the height of the snap. Diameter is 1.6D. Here you could see I'm drawing the same arrangement here also to the other side, just to make you understand how to draw the snap head. I'm making a mark here. That intersection from the bottom dot, 0.70. Okay, then you need to draw a semicircle. Okay, as I said, the overall radius is 1.60. So from this point, have a look. With the help of compass, make a mark. Just to place this 1.6D, I'm working out. 1.6d is the diameter, so to take it as a radius, 1.6d by 2, and draw up a curve on either sides. Okay, when I consider 1.6d by 2, 1.6d by 2, from the top intersection of 0.7d, make a mark of 1.6d by 2. It will cross this top horizontal, taking that as center, draw a curve of 1.6d by 2. Okay. So all complete explanation you could see in actual video. Here I am trying to give you some voiceover. There in the actual video you find, you can actually hear me properly there, complete explanation. Then with a diameter of D, draw two parallel lines which are invisible. Just have a look, same practice I am doing, 0.70 is marking. Okay, 1.6d by 2, from here make a mark of 1.6d by 2, nothing but half, that as center, draw the curve. Okay, this is how the arrangement of rivet is going to be. Again, take the projectile lines to draw the top view. Okay, this is our next topic. So here I am trying to give you a small introduction about. Let me forward this a bit faster so that you'll understand. This is how it is going to be. All these explanations I am going to give you bit by bit, one after the other, in the coming lectures. Okay. Now your work is try to finish off by buying A3 size drawing book. A3 size drawing book. Start working on conventional representation of materials. Then the second sheet is conventional representation of machine components. Three tables you have in that. After finishing those two, try to draw hexagonal nut, hexagonal bolt, square nut, square bolt. You find in your textbook the same, with same specifications. Try to draw just by looking at the drawing. Okay, no need to remember and draw. Firstly, when you present it on your sheet of paper, try to look at the textbook. By looking at the textbook, draw the sketches. That is important. Try to remember dimensions. Okay. After completing hexagonal, square, nut, bolts, try to draw forms of threads or types of threads. There are six types of threads which I have just now explained you. Do that practice. That is your fourth sheet. After completing the fourth sheet, we'll work on riveted joints. Okay. Try to go through this video. If you have any difficulty of understanding the dimensions or the profiles drawing, let me know in the next class. If you have any queries, you can ask me now. I'm about to close the session, and somebody take the responsibility and take a snapshot of your attendance and send it to my personal WhatsApp number. Okay, if you have any queries, you can raise your voice, unmute and talk to me. Shall I close the session? Send me your attendance. Chain type, zigzag type, all these arrangements I just explain you in the next class. As of now, you people just go through it once. Shall I close the session? Send me your attendance. Somebody can answer me. Shall I close? Do you have any doubts? How big explanation I may give, still you find difficulty in understanding because we are offline, we are online. So when we discuss offline, then you'll understand things in a better way, maybe. But please go through the videos which I have posted in the channel, which will help you out. Utilize the time properly, make use of those videos, that will help you seriously. Okay. Somebody posted me attendance. Thank you for that. And I'm going to leave now. Do you have any doubts or shall I leave? That is all for today. And we'll continue with the riveted joints in the next class. Okay. Thank you.